Welcome to Family Worship. We're so excited to have you with us as we worship God, as we pray together, and as we learn more about Jesus as we investigate him in Luke's Gospel. Is everyone here this morning? We need to check you're all here before we can get started. So Torches, give us a big wave, shout us a big hello if you're there.
Hello!
Hi Torches. Sparklers, if you're here with us this morning, why don't you do the same? Get up and give us a wave hello.
Hey Sparklers! Fireflies, are you there? I think you might give us the biggest hello this morning. Come on, let's hear a big one.
Hello! Hi Fireflies. And Crash, if you're there, why don't you give us a wave too?
Hello everyone in Crash. Well, today we're going to be talking about having a party. I can't wait. I love parties and I'm really missing them at the moment. Laura, what's been the best party you've ever been to?
Good question. I think it would be the surprise 21st my housemates threw me a few years ago.
Surprise parties are so exciting. Mm.
It was really, really fun. They made me a cake and it was a complete surprise. I had no idea it was happening. It was so much fun. How about you, Faye? What's the best party you've ever been to?
Ooh, I'm not sure I can remember all the parties I've been to, but last year we had a party for my husband Derek's 30th birthday, and it was really good because there was food and we had games, and someone taught us how to do swing dancing, which was really fun and kind of different, which I enjoyed.
Games and food and dancing. That sounds like a really good party.
How about you at home? Take a few minutes now to talk together as a family. What's been your favourite party that you've been to or that someone has thrown for you? Have some time to talk about that now. Let's stand up and get ready to worship God this morning with our whole bodies. Today we're going to do some party moves to get us warmed up, some dance moves that you might do at a party. So, first one, are you ready to stretch up? Yeah! Come on! Now the other way. How about the swimming dance move? Get those arms stretching. And what about a good twist? Yeah. Okay. I hope you're warmed up at home. I think we're warmed up.
We've got a new song for you this morning. We think some of you might know it already. It's about praising God because he sent Jesus to rescue us. Let's get ready to worship together.
Lord, I lift your name on high.
Lord, I lift your name on high. Lord, I love to sing your praises. I'm so glad you're in my life. I'm so glad. you came to save us. You came from heaven to earth to show the way, from the earth to the cross, my debt to pay, from the cross to the grave, from the grave to the sky. Lord, I lift your name on high. Lord, I lift your name on high. Lord, I love to sing your praises. I'm so glad you're in my life. I'm so glad you came to save us. You came from heaven to earth to show the way, from the earth to the cross, my debt to pay, from the cross to the grave, from the grave to the sky, Lord, I lift your name on high.
This week we're looking at Luke chapter 14. We've got so far through the book of Luke. And we're going to look at a parable Jesus told, a story about someone who threw a really big party. So we thought we'd have our own party right here this week.
That sounds like a great idea. I wonder what we'll need for a great party. Can you guys at home think of anything we might need for a party?
Yeah, when you have a party for maybe your birthday, what things do you need to get ready? Can you help us? Can you give us some ideas? Shout them out. What do we need for a party?
Yeah, I've got balloons, and party hats, and bunting.
Okay, I think we've got all we need. It's time to decorate the room!
We're back. What do you think?
I'm so excited for our party. We've got our balloons, our bunting, our party hats. It's really party time!
But the other important thing we need for a party is people.
Yes.
Look, Faith, there's Farmer Trevor. Trevor, come join us. Our party's ready to start. Come on, quickly.
Oh, howdy, guys. Oh, this just looks great. But sadly, I don't think I'll be able to join you at the party today. I'm just a bit busy.
Oh no, Farmer Trevor. But we sent you the invitation months ago and you replied to say you were coming. We were so excited. Farmer Trevor is going to be at our party.
Oh, I know. But I've actually just purchased a brand new carrot field and I need to go and see how much damage all this snow has been doing. Oh, please excuse me. I gotta go. Have a fun party. Bye, guys.
Bye.
What a shame. I was really looking forward to having loads of guests.
Yeah.
It's a good thing we've invited some other people too, though.
Yeah.
Look, here's the little Rupert. Rupert, come and join us. Come on, our party's ready to start.
Oh, hi everyone. Oh, what did you order again? Oh, I must have forgotten. Is it a pizza? A takeaway? No, I remember. You're throwing a party, aren't you? Oh, I'd totally forgotten. I don't think I'm going to be able to make it.
And you replied to say you'd be there. What could be so important? And it's this party of the year.
Well, what can I say? Business has been booming right now, and I've been delivering absolutely non-stop. In fact, I've just had to upgrade my bike to get a motorbike. So I'm going to go and collect it now and take it for a spin. Oh, it's going to be lovely.
Oh, well, make sure you get yourself a better helmet than that one for a motorbike.
Yeah.
Stay safe.
See you guys. Have a good one.
What? A disappointment. I thought we'd have at least one guest by now.
Yeah.
But wait, here comes Mr. Valentine.
Yes.
And it looks like he's dressed up really smartly just for our party.
Come on.
How exciting is this?
Here comes the groom, fed up with rue. It's such a beautiful day, cause I am in love.
Mr. Valentine, it's time for our party. Come join us.
Oh, it's wonderful to see you. Oh, isn't today just the best? I feel so happy and joyful because I'm in love. Oh, wait, your party's today? Oh no, that's a real shame. Oh, you see, today's actually Valentine's Day, and as I've only just got married, I really should be spending it all with Mrs. Valentine.
Well, we invited you both. We sent the invitation. It's for you and Mrs. Valentine. Please come to our party.
Oh, I'm terribly sorry, but we just won't be able to fit it in. We're so busy with all our other Valentine's activities. You know, get some takeaway flat whites, go rowing by the river, gazing adoringly into one another's eyes. Oh, you know, that sort of thing. I should actually get going. I'm due to meet her any minute now. Hope you have a good time.
Bye. Wait, this means no one's going to come to our party. What a disaster. What are we going to do? We spent such a long time preparing, Faye.
Why don't we go back to what Jesus was saying? We're looking at Luke 14 today, and he's telling this parable. He's really wise. We learned that last week. He knows what to do in difficult situations. And in this parable Jesus tells, he talks about this man throwing a party, and these guests, they made all these excuses one after another. He was in the same situation. But then the man hosting the party, when he heard about this, he told his servant, go out again. Invite anyone you can find, all sorts of people all over town, even those who can't invite you back to a party.
But I might not even know those people that well. Why would I want to invite them to my party?
Well, Jesus tells us we should invite many different people to a party because that's what Jesus is like. That's what God's like. Before you knew Jesus, you were a stranger to him, but he welcomed you, he invited you to be his friend. That's what Jesus is like. He invites everyone and anyone to join him at the great party he's going to have at the end of time.
That sounds like the best party ever. Now I can see why you would invite everyone, even people that you don't know that well. It's so that we can invite them in the same way that Jesus invited us.
Yeah, that's right. Jesus said that the man throwing the party wanted to make sure his house was full. He invited as many people as possible. Jesus gave us this example to show us what he's like and how we can be like him.
Detective Agent Holmes here. Thank you so much for helping me in my investigation last week into who Jesus is while I was out getting more clues. I knew I'd left the case in safe hands. From the notes you left me, I've been able to deduce that Jesus is wise. And this week's investigation took us to a party, and we met lots of special guests. Our evidence includes some invitations and party hats, which seem to show that Jesus invites us to be his friends. Not only this, but he wants us to welcome all the people we know too, because he welcomed us first. I wonder where our investigation will take us next week. Who will we meet? But for now, I think we can call this case closed.
We hope you had fun doing last week's challenge, going out and looking at all the birds and the flowers out and about. Here's a few pictures of some of the children and kids at King's who were out looking at flowers last week. This week's challenge is related to Valentine's Day. Today is a day about showing love to people, and it doesn't just have to be that romantic, smushy kind of love. We challenge you to think about someone that you know who might just need someone to show them some love right now. It might be someone who lives in your house. It might be a grandparent who maybe lives alone and you could send them a letter, or maybe someone on your street or a friend. Think about what you could do to show them love. You could write a letter and post it to someone if they live far away. You could leave some flowers on the doorstep of someone on your street, or maybe you could bake someone a cake in your house. What could you do this week to show someone some love? That's your challenge. For the craft this week, we're going to make our own party hats to think about how Jesus has welcomed us to his party. Have fun decorating yours, painting them, adding sparkly things, and think about maybe you could have your own party at home during half term to celebrate that. We hope you have fun. It's time for another song. It's one that we've been enjoying this term at Family Worship, Jesus, Friend of Sinners. Now, I wonder if you know why we do some of the actions for these songs. When we do this action for Jesus' name, it's because we're remembering that This is where the nails went into his hands when he died for us on the cross. So this is our Jesus action. And then this is friend, because friends like to hold hands and be close to each other. So it's reminding us that Jesus is our friend and he wants to be close to us. Let's sing Jesus, Friend of Sinners.
There is a voice that must be heard. There is a song that must be sung. There is a name that must be lifted high. There is a treasure more than gold. There is a king upon the throne. There is one whose praise will fill the sky. His name is Jesus, Friend of sinners. Jesus, Jesus, Friend of mine. There is a peace that comes of this. There is a love stronger than death. There is a hope that goes beyond the grave. There is a friend who won't let go. There is a heart that beats for you. There is one name by which we are saved. His name is Jesus, Friend of sinners. Jesus, Jesus, Friend of mine, Friend of mine. When I was captive to my fears, you were the one who came to me. You set me free.
Family are going to lead us in prayer all about love because it's Valentine's Day today. Over to the Wiles.
Hi everyone, as it's Valentine's Day today, we thought that we would pray about people knowing God's love and also the love of others. So kids, each time I hold up this heart, please can you say or shout the word love?
So let's pray. Father God, thank you for showing us how much you
love
us in Jesus. We pray that we would all know that you
love
us so much it's more than we can imagine. We pray for people that don't know your
love,
that you would make your
love
real to them. Help us to
love
others and show others your
love
by how we treat them. Help us to be kind and generous. We pray especially for those that are isolated and lonely at this time, that they would still know
love
of friendship and family, even if they can't love. See them at the moment. God, thank you that you are
love.
In Jesus' name,
Amen.
For our final song, I think it's one of your favourites. It's My Lighthouse.
In my wrestling and in my doubt, in my fears, you won't walk out. Your great love will lead me through. You are the peace in my trouble, see. Oh, you are the peace in my trouble. In the silence, you won't let go. In the questions, your truth will hold. Your great love will lead me through. You are the peace in my troubled sea. Oh, you are the peace in my troubled sea. My lighthouse, shining in the darkness. I will follow you. My lighthouse, I was just a promise. You are carrying me safe to shore. I won't fear what tomorrow brings. With each morning I'll rise and sing. My God's love will lead me through. You are the peace in my troubled sea. Oh, you are the peace in my troubled sea. My lighthouse, my lighthouse, shining darkness, I will follow you. Oh, my lighthouse, I was just a promise. You are carrying me safe to shore, safe to shore, safe to shore, safe to shore.
Now, can anybody tell me what noise a lighthouse makes? Yeah, you're quite right. It doesn't really make very much noise. So we're going to sing the chorus one last time, very, very quietly.
My lighthouse, shining in the darkness, I will follow you. My lighthouse, I was just a promise. You are carrying me safe to shore. Safe to shore. Safe to shore. Safe to shore.
Thanks for coming. It was great to see you, as always. One extra notice from us this week as that because it's 10:30, we're not going to be doing the Sparklers and Torches Zoom. So enjoy your half-term holiday and we'll see you on the Zoom calls next Monday.
And a reminder about the challenge to show some love to someone who you think might be lonely at the moment, and also to do the craft to make a party hat.
We'll be back next Sunday at 9:30, as always, to find out what we can learn about Jesus from Luke's Gospel. See you there!